It was not just the secretary. The entire political system was Democrats, Republican. We've essentially subsidized housing in lots of different ways for the last 20 years. We've invested too much in homes that are not really increasing productivity, not enough in machines that increase productivity of labor. So there's been a distorted economy. Too much money is going into housing, not enough in other stuff. And now we're paying the consequences by having the biggest housing and mortgage crisis since the Great Depression. It's really severe, and it's not being resolved.
To some extent, I think that we are in the midst of something that has become much bigger than a credit crunch. It has morphed into an economic crisis. Therefore, we need crisis management. By definition, crisis management means living in the world of third or fourth best. And what you got on Sunday is a bold attempt to change the regime. And I agree with the notion that it is necessary. It is also likely not to be sufficient. And the big question is whether it gives the system some time to get back on side. Beyond that, I think we're going to look back and say, wow, that was another unthinkable that has become thinkable. When you think about it, what happened? First, we've got the public balance sheet that's being brought into the equation. Secondly, the government is no longer targeting just Freddie and Fannie, as important as they are. It is targeting the mortgage market. It is targeting housing because it has realized that unless you stabilize housing, you cannot start rehabilitating other parts of the economy. And thirdly, critically, if you're an economist, you say, finally, the fiscal instrument is being brought into play. So far, we've relied too much on the monetary instrument, and the monetary instrument has proved ineffective for the extent of our problems. So it's a step forward. It's a necessary step. But I agree that this is far from the end.
I have been so disappointed throughout this entire process at the lack of recognition of our policymakers that there was a problem. For months, the problem was going to be contained to subprime. Then when they acknowledged it, it was going to, you know, maybe seep into other areas. I mean, it has been just denial upon denial upon denial of this problem. I don't think that any American can have the confidence that these people are going to be straight with them about how big a problem it is and whether there are solutions that are being struck. Everything always seems to me to be sort of a Band-Aid put on a gaping wound.
Interesting question that is now a political question is what to do about defaulted mortgages and about mortgages that may go into default. To the extent that Fannie and Freddie are now real government enterprises, the government is going to be the one making these decisions on many of these mortgages.
Join us online at charlierose.com.